others as well, welcome. I'm going to do a presentation on behalf of Hewlett Packard Enterprise. Because of the limited time, I will, of course, the portfolio and the solution of Hewlett Packard Enterprise is very large, so I will not speak about maybe our most popular products, the servers. I will not cover this. I will not speak about the storage. The presentation, like the title tells you, will go around about networking, optimized networks for cloud and mobile. Why cloud and mobile? When we step back years, we're coming from mainframe terminal environment, but years ago, when I was a small boy. Later on, you have the client-server environment. And what we see now is, because of the internet, because of tablets, smartphones, we move to what we call a cloud mobile IT infrastructure. And due to this, IT, of course, must follow and evolve. Talking about networking, just a little bit look back. Some of you are thinking, are we new in networking? No. We are more than almost 40 years in networking. The reason why I'm highlighting this is, in the beginning, our portfolio was more low-end, unmanaged switching. Of course, if you enter a new market, you try to change. You want to bring some change to the market. I want to highlight one thing, which is still the case today, which you see here. At that time, we were the first in the market who were offering on the switching portfolio lifetime warranty, which is still the case today. And our customers like this because it's drive down operational cost, of course. So still today, let's say on the less critical switches in the network, customers use lifetime warranty. And you're building your portfolio through own development, own R&D, and through acquisition. There are two acquisitions I'm going to highlight. One important one was in 2010, here, down right, was the acquisition of Tricom. We acquired Tricom in 2010 because we were missing a high-end switching portfolio, missing a data center portfolio. We needed to be ready for this cloud and this data center. I come back to this later. The recent acquisition, which is closed now, is the acquisition of Aruba. So in the presentation, I'm gonna tell you about a few trends we see in the market. Through this, I hope to explain you why, and I hope it will become clear why we have acquired Aruba. We want to position in an area, of course, where there is growth in the market. Later on, I'm going to highlight a few solutions and differentiators. That's how I will move through my presentation. A picture of 2005. Who does recognize the picture, the place? It's somewhere in Europe. It's in Italy. 2005, it's in Rome, it's the election of the Pope. People are waiting to see the new Pope, 2005. I'm going to show you more or less same place, few meters different, same event is happening, election of the Pope in 2013. You see the switch in 8 years. You were there. Okay, you've seen it before. So this picture tells us it's the adoption of mobile, clearly. It's people with smartphones and with tablets. But this has an impact as well, not only on the consumer, but those people are moving into our building, are today, are working on our premises. So they are expecting some change from IT as well. They are expecting some, they have some needs, they are expecting some tools. So what is changing? As well is changing. Don't know why. So what is changing? the first thing to the right, wireless Wi-Fi has become the preferred way to connect to the net. Being it, we want to be connected in a hotel, in an airport, at home, even when we walk in the office, the preferred way of connecting, being connected, it became wireless. And today the technology is there to unplug what you can call the unplug the desktop. The bandwidth is there. At the end, we don't need cables anymore. So that's a fact. Second, because we more and more, we use smartphones, we use tablets. I think nobody of you has a smartphone or a tablet with an Ethernet port. There are no Ethernet ports on those devices. So the way we download apps, the way we are going to install apps is on the App Store. So we download applications from the App Store. It's not like before anymore. Before, if you go back, if you wanted a new application on your desktop, on your portable, you had to go to IT, you had to fill in forms, big discussion with IT, maybe 3-4 months later, there was a new application. That's not, as a user, what we expect as a service from IT. To give you an example, yesterday evening, we were doing the checking in on the hotel. The lady was asking me, do you have a reward card? I said, yes. I took my mobile, I opened an app where I have all my loyalty cards. My colleague next to me was asking me, what kind of app is this? I told him, 3 minutes later, the app is installed. Guess what? That's the kind of service that the user is expecting from IT. Next to this, unified communication and collaboration. In our private life, we are used to work with WhatsApp, Skype, Apple Time. Here in those applications, you see people online, and it's pretty easy when the name is green, you tap on the name, I need a little bit of water, just a moment.
Thank you.
Sorry for that. So, in my private life, what I was saying, when people are online and they are green, you just tap on the name, it's easy to initiate a call. It's easy to initiate a video call. This is exactly what people expect when they are collaborating in the office as well. So we see, of course, we need more enterprise-grade applications compared to the WhatsApp or the Skype. Now, the biggest challenge. Security. Again, as a business user, I don't care about security. Security is not my problem. Security is a problem for IT. That's how I think. Security, IT needs to take care about it. Now, looking at IT, that's a challenge. If you look at the old IT model, on security, IT is monitoring Ethernet ports because this is within the perimeter. When there is a problem with Ethernet port 55, per definition, there was one user behind Ethernet port 55, so there's a problem with that user. In the new model, when we start deploying wireless and mobility, behind the Ethernet port, there's an access point. Behind an access point, there can be 15, 20 users. So here you see that the old model based on Ethernet ports and behind an Ethernet port, a VLAN, with one security policy and a quality of service is under pressure. Here IT needs new tools. The last point is And here you make the link between cloud and mobile, it's the cloud. So applications, when I'm a user, I'm expecting that the application is running, up and running, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And that's, for being IT, you need rock solid data center infrastructure. Before we could afford to define Windows, that is no longer the case. You need to have all the time an up and running IT infrastructure. So these are challenges, trends I have plotted. Let's now look at, and here you find the motivation for the acquisition of Aruba. So what does the two companies bring to the table? If you look at HP, and you can look at it from different angles, but if you look at HP and first the technology angle, what does we bring to the table? We are the number two in switching. And I did not understand the previous language, I didn't understand your language, but in the previous presentation about the case study, and when I was looking at the physical environment, it was a case study built on switching of HP with IRF technology. So we have today, we are the number two, we have a leading switching portfolio, access switching, aggregation, data center switching. We are recognized as a leader in software-defined networking. At the Aruba side, what does they bring to the table? It's leading wireless infrastructure, access points, controller-less, controller-based, combined with mobility solutions. And there is a difference between wireless and mobility. Wireless mainly refers to the infrastructure. Mobility is another challenge, and we'll come back to that. Now, if you look at from a geographical perspective, Aruba is strong in Americas. HP is stronger in EMEA region and China. You can see that is in the local presence here as well. Look at the presence of HP, look at the presence of Aruba. So this is why Aruba needs HP. Because great solution, great technology, but you need, at the moment, you need to be able to scale it. Just a quote of Gart, who confirms, so it's Gartner, an extremely industry watcher, who is saying, okay, number two in switching, number two in wireless. All clients globally should consider the new company, Hewlett Packard Enterprise Aruba, for all white wireless LAN access layer opportunities. Probably you know the Gartner quadrant. This was the Gartner quadrant, wired and wireless, September 2013. Probably you cannot read the names. No. The light blue bullet is a HP networking. The orange bullet is Aruba. Upright, we have Cisco, to name a few. What is the evolution? This is the quadrant June 2014. Now, as a vendor, it's your intention to be upright. Why do you need to be upright? On the horizontal axis, you have vision, vertical, you have execution. The more to the right you are, the better your vision, the better your technology. The more up you are, probably linked with your market share, your presence in the market. Look, also, so you want to be upright. Why do you need to be there as a vendor? Because you need sales for you. You can have great technology, but if you don't sell, you have no revenue, and you cannot invest in R&D, and you are pushed out of the market. Typically also, customers will avoid to buy leftover. Why? Those are niche players. That's a risk. Those are the companies who can be bought by another. We also see this as an evolution. Look at how many dots you have left, how many dots you have right. There are a few examples in the industry the last 5 years. So we are now positioned clearly extreme racks to the right, and we need to move up a little bit. That's why we are counting on you. Differentiator solutions. 3. Agile data center, digital workplace, adaptive trust. That's what we bring to you. Agile data center. What the focus today, what I want to highlight is we need a more flexible data center infrastructure. If you look at how many application updates you will have to deal with in the future, compared to the past, you see a few figures here, left up, for a year before, or a few per year, you could have maintenance windows. That's no longer the case. Look how many applications updates you're receiving on your tablets and smartphone. So this means that before, in the data center, a lot was based on manual command line programming. This can no longer be the case because it takes too much time. It needs to be scalable, so we are moving from a hardware-defined to a software-defined world in the data center, being it on network, on storage, and so on servers. One quote here from Gartner is HP Packard, I need to get used to it. Hewlett Packard Enterprise is recognized as one of the most open vendors when it comes down to data center switching. And it's a must for us, because often we are moving into a competitive install base. So this means that you need to be open, to be compatible, interoperable with the existing vendor, which is not always the case if you're a market leader. Second, digital workplace. What is changing here? So this means the work environment in your company. What you see is, when I started working, there were no portables, there were also only desktop PCs connected with a cable. So I could not take my work home. I had to take my desktop PC. Now you see the portables. I could take my portable home in a corner in the living room, little desk for home office. And discussions around work-life balance. Now the new generation, we call them Gen Mobile, Generation Mobile. The new generation, the younger ones even, and some of you here in the room, they don't care about working hours. They want to be connected all the time. They want to have access all the time to the resources, applications, information needed to do the job. And they want to do this with a device of their choice. That's a fact. You cannot have a smartphone, private one, and one for business. You cannot have a tablet, two tablets. They want to have one device. As a result, what we see is that work offices are changing as well. Before we had the cubes, when you were walking into a meeting room, you open your portable. At that time, you're starting a session. Your portable detects the access points, opening a session. When the meeting is finished, you close your portable. You stop your session. So at the end, let me say, I can call it the old wireless. It's just a wireless extension of an Ethernet port. When you start with open offices, start with mobile devices, here you don't close applications. You like the room. So you're walking around from one corner to another corner, the session is open. So the need to intelligence in the wireless environment, infrastructure, which is handing over a device from one access point to another, the performance is going to drop. So this is the kind of intelligence which is building. As I said, today we want to do our job from wherever we are, wherever we want. And we want to do it, we want to have the same, the business user want to have the same quality of performance working from home, in a public environment, in a branch or a headquarter. That's the need, that's the ask towards IT. So therefore, what we need is an application-aware infrastructure. So what I mean by this is, if you have 1 gigabit throughput to an access point, as IT, you do not want during business hour that people use all of the percentage for social media or to watch videos, not during business hours. So maybe after business hours. So the infrastructure as such need to have the capabilities to recognize applications, and from IT, if we have this infrastructure, we can define priorities. That's what we need and that's what we bring to the table. Last one, adaptive trust. Meaning, I'm gonna adapt the trust I'm give depending on the situation. Before, it was pretty simple. Everything was cabling. Now, the environment within my premises, per definition, were secured and were green. The outside world was red. In between, a big wall, what we call a firewall. If you wanted to have, if you were at the outside, and you wanted to have access to the inside, to information or an application, you start a VPN. As you see on the slide, this doesn't work anymore. Per definition, the threat, the danger in the new world is coming from within. Your employees are bringing devices, their smartphones or tablets, in the perimeter, and they want to connect. So per definition, everything is red now. So we need to change our security model. So the old model, which is typically AAA based, authentication, authorization, accounting, it does work, but it doesn't work anymore in a bring your own device world, in the mobile world. So we're gonna change the way we do security. We're gonna change it, instead of being Ethernet port based, we are going to give access depending on a few parameters. Depending on who wants to have access, with what kind of device does the person want to have access, what kind of applications does the customer, the user want to have access to, what time of the day. Depending on all those parameters, we're going to give access. The solution we bring forward here through the acquisition is ClearPass, which is a AAA solution, but with add-ons like guest access, like solution to onboard devices, a solution to check devices, because in the bring your own world, as an IT, what you don't want to do is install software on each device. This is not what you can do. To summarize, so what we see is that it's time to change from a world which was port defined to software defined, from a more static world to a more dynamic world, a security model which is changing towards a context-based security model, the model giving access depending on who you are, what kind of device, which application, what time of the day. With that, maybe not within the 15 minutes, I want to thank you for your attention. And if you have today challenges on security with bringing your own device, or your plan to roll out a strategy, mobile applications, talk to us. There's a good chance that we can offer you a solution. Thank you very much.